Namaste, Jai Shivai. I'm here in the bright canyons today. Very peaceful, and occasionally people are crossing from here and that's it. So today many people have asked me which books to read, what books you should be reading when it comes to gather some gyan, some wisdom. So I would say that, you know, if you really want to read the books, then check the author first. A lot of people, those who have written the books in English, they were not the spiritual journey walkers themselves. They just were scholars, Western scholars, scholars of Sanskrit, scholars of theology, scholars of Indian Vedas and Shastras and scriptures, and that's how they end up writing a book as a thesis for their program or as a report or research report, you can say. So that's how the books were written. Long back in 1800s, Max Müller and Griswold and all these people, they actually tried to translate Vedas and they did it all wrong. The unconscious people, those who are unconscious, when they start writing the books about consciousness or the books about how to be 100% conscious, then definitely their own vasanas and their own mental projection that they have, their own social conditioning, mental projection, all that, you know, is just reflected into the book instead of real translation. Because the Vedas, the scriptures that have been written, the Tantra, the Kundalini books that have been written, it's not just a case of translation, it also requires interpretation. And that's where things go wrong. That's where the social mental conditioning and the mental projection that they have, that is what starts reflecting. Because you cannot understand, say for example, if I ask you to define courage, right? Forget about ultimate truth and Brahma or the Shiva. Forget about that. Just take simple thing as courage. So if you want to define courage or write a book about courage, then if your life experience is like, you know, standing up and really fighting and facing your spouse, suppose you have a difficult spouse, and then that's what your courage is all about, every time standing up for the right thing in the house. So your interpretation of courage will go only so far, right? But if you are in a armed forces, in the services, then your courage, the idea of courage, will go all the way to the battlefield, all the way taking bullets, all the way being on front line and all that. So your courage, the definition and the interpretation of courage will expand. So, or if you have been a spiritual journey walker, then courage will be something else for you. If you have been deeply, sincerely in love, then courage will be totally something else for you. So you see how the context that you have in your life, the life experiences that you have, how they change how you interpret different words, courage, love, compassion, how you interpret them, all that keeps on changing, right? So exactly in the same way when it comes to the ultimate truth, if you are not walking your own spiritual journey, then your definition of courage or definition of ultimate reality or the truth will not go very far. You'll never, most of the people in the world are actually so much bound by the lower three chakras. So when they try to translate the book or interpret something that is from the Vedas, Upanishads, or other Brahmanas, or other Dvaita, dualism, non-dualism, or, you know, a special dualism kind of theories, all those theories, when they try to interpret it, it's going to have a reflection of the lower three chakra people. Because if you are not transforming yourself, there is no way you are going to interpret it correctly. So whenever you are reading books, try to read the books that have been written by those who were walking their own spiritual journey. And especially when they have walked the journey all the way till Agya Chakra. And if you get stuck anywhere in between, there is no way you see the Brahma. There is no way to interpret it. No matter how much languages or words or theories you try to put into it, no matter what you try to do, it's never going to come out right from you. First thing, these things are not meant for language. That is one thing. But still, if you are trying to understand them verbally, mentally, if you are trying to progress on your journey through jnana, then if you are trying to read these books, then the most important thing is that you actually read the books that have been written by those who have walked their spiritual journey, who have the idea of what they are talking about. Until the transformation, why are we writing or reading or even these books exist? These books exist to transform you. But instead of using them for transforming yourself, if you just go on doing mental gymnastics about it, or if you are doing some kind of a spiritual entertainment, you're trying to become world famous by writing a book, then you will, most of the time, you'll end up just writing your own mental fantasy. So don't read the books from these kind of people, those who have written the books, those who do not have a correct interpretation, and those who are not like that, those who haven't walked their own spiritual journey. Do not read the books from them. Especially when it comes to the Kundalini books, I would say you should never read any book that is for Kundalini, and that has been written by some Western scholars. Those who have partially taken the idea of Kundalini, tried to map it to the gross body, which is, I don't know what kind of, it's sort of nonsense actually, if you would see. If your Kundalini rises, if your chakras starts awakening, you will realize that it has nothing to do with the gross body, the physical body, the Annamaya Kosha. It has actually nothing to do. Because you want to see everything, connect everything from the gross in a very hardcore manner. No. You may think that there is a pineal gland and it's a third eye, and if we do some kind of surgery there, then third eye will open up. No. Nothing like that happens. No matter how much you dissect or try to connect things with the gross world through your physical body, that is not how it works. That is not how it is. And to understand the language of subtle, to understand the world of subtle, you need a direct experience of it. Okay? And oftentimes, why do you want to read it? Because you want some kind of justification, some kind of certification. Then trust that every knowledge, everything that you want to know will come from within. Sooner or later, these things will come from within. Because Kundalini and chakras awakening means you are becoming more and more conscious. So how come it is that you have to go and ask somebody else? Or if you want to read some description in the book and try to match your experience with the book. So don't do all these things. This is just a time waste. I would say rather spend a lot of time in your sadhana than reading the wrong interpretations and then trying to match the experience with your own and then thinking either nothing has happened to you or thinking very confident that, okay, I reached this milestone. And no, that is not how it works. Reaching the milestones in the subtle world, if you have a good guru, please go to them and ask them, I would say, rather than reading books and stuff. Because your experience of the gross, of the subtle world is going to be according to your chitta vrittis, according to the chitta that you have, according to the inner space that you have. Yes, the cosmic experience remains same. The cosmic consciousness remains same. But when you try to, when it has to be translated through your existence, when it has to be interpreted through your existence, then it's your inner space where it is going to be playing out, right? Where it is going to be interpreted. So your inner space varies from one person's inner space varies from the other person. So it's better not to get into too much of mental gymnastics about these things. Better to talk to your guru, ask your guru. And if you still really want to read the books, then I am yet to come upon one good English book. It's not that they may not be existing as of now. It's just that my focus totally was, until now, was walking just my own journey and not relying so much on the book or somebody else's interpretation, because that's what the yogic path, the spiritual path, is all about. Coming up, walking your own journey, going through your own transformation, and that takes the life out of you. That takes all the time, all the energy that you have. So you're not left with a lot of time to do mental gymnastics. So if you want to really read the books, then read the books from those scholars or those people, those who have walked their own journey, those who are spiritual journey walkers, not just scholars doing some research and trying to write something and translating something from Sanskrit or Hindi. Gita Press has some really good books in Hindi if you can read. Shokhamba Publications also publishes some good books. There are some other books. Sometime I'll publish a list of books that I would really recommend other people to read. But other than that, just focus a lot on your sadhana, on your spiritual journey, rather than, doing mental jnana. It's of no use. Mental jnana is okay, but it can only take you so far. It's the real transformation within that gives you the real jnana, the real wisdom. Hope you understand that. Namaste. Jai Shivaji.